Welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to draft a tiered skirt, which is a variation on the classic dirndle gathered skirt. It is drafted with rectangles, which can be cut narrower for a boho skirt look or cut fuller for a square dance petticoat style. Check out my Patreon in the description below for a written guide for this tutorial and options for private tutoring in CLO3D. Let's get started. Go ahead and open the gathered skirt project file. It's available on my Patreon, or you can work through the gathered skirt tutorial. The link is in the description. In the project file, you can see I have this pattern piece, which I have labeled as the skirt waistband elastic, this piece, which is the skirt waistband, and then a skirt back left, center front, and back right. Before we draft this gathered skirt into a tiered skirt, the only measurement that we need to calculate is the length of the skirt divided by 3. So if I go to the Edit Pattern tool or the Z hotkey right up here in the 2D toolbar, I can just click on any of these lines and it'll show me the length of this rectangle, which is the length of the skirt, and it's 36 inches. So 36 divided by 3 is 12, and that measurement is also in the description. All right, we could just break this skirt into different tiers now, but I know that when we create the next couple layers, the tiers are going to get wider. And so to avoid having to break these apart in later steps, I'm just going to go ahead and divide them into 4 equal parts now. So going to the internal polygon tool, which is the G hotkey, right up here in the 2D toolbar, I'm just going to click on point A right up here. It's in the middle of the skirt center front piece. And then I am going to double click on point B, and that will just create a line that bisects this pattern. Once I've done that, I can go to the transform pattern tool, which is the A hotkey, or right here in the 2D toolbar, and right click this line and then choose cut and sew. And that will cut along that line while also creating the sewing lines so that it remains sewn together. Okay, now we are ready to divide these pieces into 3 different tiers. So I'm going to go to the Edit Pattern tool. Again, that's right here in the 2D toolbar, or the Z hotkey. And I'm going to hold Shift and click the top of each of these skirt patterns. So I have 4 selected. And once they're selected, I'm going to right click the selection and choose Offset as Internal Line. All right, so now here is where that calculation came in. So number of offsets, we want to be 2 because we're going to make 3 tiers. And then for the distance, we're going to choose that number that we calculated. So for me, my skirt was 36 inches long. That divided by 3 is 12. And you can see that there's 3 equal segments being created, and that looks good. Reverse direction, don't click that, but extend should be selected, and then click OK. All right, with the Edit Pattern tool still selected, we can right click these lines and choose Cut and Sew. Notice that I can get to the Cut and Sew menu using either the Edit Pattern tool or the Transform Pattern tool. Either of them will give me this option. All right, now we have our 3 separate tiers. I'm going to call this top tier Tier 1, this middle one Tier 2, and then the third one Tier 3. So going to the Transform Pattern tool, or the A hotkey, I'm going to shift click all of the tiers in Tier 2. And then with the bounding box, I'm just going to click the side and then drag it out. And while I am dragging it out, I'm not going to let go of the left clicker. I'm just going to right click and it'll bring up the transform window, and then I can type in a percentage. And for this tutorial, I'm just going to go ahead and put 200%. Once you've kind of looked at this with the length of your skirt and everything, you can always go back and change this percentage. But I think that this is a nice place to start given the style of skirt I'm going for. And then I'm going to go ahead and click OK. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and try to simulate this, and we're going to see what happens. And if it doesn't work out well, I'll show you a couple other methods to make the simulation go a little bit smoother. So when I simulate, you know, it's kind of adding quite a bit of fullness. Thankfully, my computer is pretty okay with it, but there is some collision. And one thing I can do is, just manually kind of pull it out while it's simulating with my little hand. But a little bit more of an eloquent solution is actually to stop simulation, select the legs, just the legs. We don't need to select any other part of the avatar. Select the legs, right click, and then choose deactivate avatar. And it will only deactivate the legs. And then when I simulate again, my skirt is free to just kind of hang out where it wants to. And it's no longer colliding with the legs. So with it kind of flown out a little bit, I can then reactivate the legs. I'm going to go ahead and leave them deactivated because for the next step. All right, so that wasn't too bad, but let's see what happens after we expand the third tier. I'll show you a few other tricks on making this simulation a little bit smoother. So the third tier, we're going to go ahead and shift click all the pieces, and then the same process, we're going to drag out this outer bounding box, and then while it's selected, right click, and this time we're going to choose 300%. So that's going to be 300% of the original one. It's basically like, here, I kind of want to zoom out so you can see what's going to happen here. It's making these tiers bigger in uniform incremental steps. So for example, the first tier is 100%, the second tier is 200%, the third tier would be 300%, and then if there was a fourth tier, it would be 400%. So that's one option for tiering your skirt. You could also choose to double the width of each tier as it went down. That would create more of a square dancing petticoat type of skirt. But I'm going for more of this kind of like free flowy boho look. So let's type in 300% and then choose OK. All right, let's see what happens when I simulate this time. See, because there's so much going on, it's kind of like pulling the skirt, it's flying into space. I think it'll eventually relax, but if your computer is not working as well as mine, this could be a really frustrating part of the process. So I'm going to just stop simulation. I'm going to do Control or Command Z to undo. And let's go ahead and deactivate these other pieces before we try to simulate. So with the Q, which is the select move tool or the transform pattern tool selected, I'm just going to select all the pieces that aren't the ones that I'm trying to simulate into place. I'm going to right click them and then choose deactivate, but pattern only, because we want to keep the sewing lines. And now I will try to simulate. And now the computer is only trying to calculate what's happening with this piece, and it's not affecting the other pieces. This is still pretty messy. I'm going to try one more thing, which is, so I'm just pausing and then going undoing. I have to undo a little bit because I was messing around. All right, now I'm going to select these four pieces in the third tier, and I'm going to right click them and then choose superimpose side, and that will put them a little bit closer. I really truly have no idea why that one's up in there. And that's a little bit better. I almost felt like the last time was more effective. The problem with superimpose side is that it's also trying to put all the pieces like next to each other using these seam lines as in addition to these seam lines. So you could try deleting these and then re-sewing them. But I honestly think we are in a little bit closer of a place. I'm going to go ahead and activate the other parts of the skirt, and then we'll see what happens. All right, so just I'm going to box select just these. I want to leave the waistband frozen because it's keeping the skirt from flying all over the place. So I'm only going to box select the tier one and tier two, and then right click in the 3D window and then choose activate. And there we go. Okay, not so bad. If you're running into any other issues with simulating this, or if you found any other tricks for this type of pattern alteration that works well, please let me know in the comments. All right, we can go ahead and reactivate the legs by right-clicking and then choosing Activate Avatar. And it looks like we don't have any issues with collision, which is great. And at this point, our skirt is essentially done. We just need to make sure that we can actually cut this out of the fabric that we have. So depending on the width of your fabric, mine is 60 inches. So I need to make sure that my pieces are less than 60 inches wide. So going to the Edit Pattern tool, or the Z hotkey, I'm just going to click on these bottom lines and see what they are. So this is 25. That's totally fine. In tier 2, we have 50, so that's fine. But tier 3 has 75. So that's a little bit wider than I need. There are a couple ways that I could split these, this tier 3 into smaller pieces. I could just bisect all of these pieces, add another internal line, and then right click cut and sew. That would create quite a few pieces though, which will be annoying to sew back together. Another option is I can go to the Edit Sewing tool, which will show me all of my sewing lines. That's the B hotkey, and it's right here in the 2D window. And then I can right click all these sewing lines and then choose merge, and it'll just basically do the opposite of cut and sew. It's merging all of these pieces together. So right click merge, and now I have one giant tier three. I'm gonna kind of move it down here so you can see it better. One giant tier three. I can go to the Z hotkey and just box select all of these internal points and then hit delete. And then we're going to go to the add point split line tool, which is the X hotkey, and it's right here in the 2D toolbar. We're going to right click this top line, and we're going to choose split by length. And then we can put in the width of our fabric, which is 60. And then we'll just up the number of segments until we have enough. So it looks like we can divide this fabric into 5 equal segments of 60. That was very convenient. And choose OK. And now with these points, we can go to the internal polygon tool. And we don't have to put points on the bottom, because we can just use the pink guidelines to draw a perpendicular line. So I'm just clicking on that first point. We'll call that point one, and then double clicking on the bottom. Point two, clicking on that, clicking on the bottom. Point three, click once, and then using that pink guideline. You can also hold shift and it will lock it to the y-axis, and then double click that bottom line. And we have those equal segments. And with those, we can go back to the transform pattern tool, or the A hotkey, and then shift click each one of those lines, and then right click, cut and sew. And when we simulate, it doesn't really show that anything happened, because we just changed where the breaks and the segments were so they could be cut out of our fabric. These final steps are just for making a nice, pretty design in the 3D window. So they're totally optional, but if you would like, go ahead and go to Fabric 1 in the Object Browser. Just click that. And then in the Property Editor, the properties for Fabric 1 will appear, and at the very bottom, let's go from Preset from Custom, and then we'll choose the Cotton Voile. And you can see now, oh, that's very lovely. That's giving you a better sense of how the cotton will act in this with this pattern. Now we want to go back into the Fabric 1, and then under Material, Basic Parameters, you can see that there is a color option. Right now it's on none, but you can click that and choose a color. I'm going to choose F5, F3, E8, and apply and close. Now I want to add a border to this pattern. So this might be an applique that's added on. It could also be a border printed fabric. But to add that, you want to go to the graphic 2D pattern in the 2D toolbar, and just clicking this will open a file browser on your computer, and you can double click floral border, which is a graphic that is available for download on my Patreon. And go ahead and click on any pattern and it will place it. The whatever width and height it comes in as is the way that I designed it. So just go ahead and leave that blank. You can leave all of this as is because we'll adjust it later, and click OK. And now you can see in the object browser under the graphic tab, the floral border appears, and we can just click and drag it to all of the other pieces one at a time. Once they're applied, you can move all of the pieces. You'll notice that CLO automatically changed my tool to transform graphic, which is right here in the 2D toolbar. And with that tool selected, you can click and drag and move all of these pieces around. I'm going to go ahead and line up the top of the border with the top of each pattern. Now, you can select all by doing Control or Command A. It'll select all of the graphics. And in the property editor, where it says tile, right now it says none. Go ahead and click the drop-down menu and then choose X-axis. And that will keep the pattern going all the way around the skirt. Once everything looks the way that you like, go ahead and go to the Select Move tool, which is in the 3D toolbar. Go ahead and click and drag around the waistband patterns. And in the 3D window, right-click the selection and then choose Unfreeze. And that will unfreeze that waistband. And the very last thing that we'll do is just stop simulation. Go to High-Res Garment in the 3D toolbar. Just choose high-res garment. I recommend choosing maybe 10 as your particle distance to start with. Click OK and then simulate. And there you go. Let me know if you have any questions, and I look forward to the next tutorial with you all.